Hello. What's up? It's that Friday episode. It's a good one. It's a good one. What do we even talk about?
Just the best thing ever, dude. Best episode ever. You're really going to want to strap in, strap on, and fucking get it, dude.
It's funny. So, yeah. Goodbye.
Yo, shut the fuck up, bro. I'm listening to Dark Race with you, man.
Racial Humor, episode 124, first trimester. I don't want to die tonight, baby. I'm gonna touch you right.
It's loud, I'm sorry. It was funny. I also have a little candy in my mouth.
Ooh, no candy on my pod. Thanks for offering me some, asshole, for sure. I'm gonna touch you right. He was like, what, 19 when he made this? Makes me feel good about myself and my personal journey. Just kidding. I'm right where I need to be. What's up, everybody? It's Dark Racial Humor. It's the Friday Eppy. Free-flowing, in-depth conversation about whatever is appropriate at the time. It's your two best friends, Bonjin.
Caller John David Ricker. Welcome in to the most profitable podcast that ever has podcasted, dude.
That's
sponsored by the Joe Budden Podcast.
Oh, I didn't get any money.
Yeah, they give us a... We're like a subsidiary.
Oh, shit. Mm-hmm. What? Our pod is way better than Joe Budden's. He just has more listeners. He's a sub of our podcast. We're the dom. He's the sub.
Is that what they're calling it in the businesses now?
We're the best podcast in the world, except... No, we're the best.
I was trying to think of one.
I made a boo-boo.
What?
Doesn't matter now, but... To the 17 people that listened to the previous episode, episode 123, I accidentally uploaded 122 to that. So people wondering, when are they going to talk about the eviction? It never happened.
What?
Yeah, but I fixed it.
Okay.
Thanks to Anchor. The fact that you can switch audio is amazing.
A sponsor.
That's great. Yeah. Audible is a sponsor. Full disclosure.
Whoa. Anchor.
Anchor is a sponsor. Audible will give us like real big boy money, but Anchor's giving us a little bit of money. Clearly your ideology is off. We are great drop. It doesn't even sound like Joe Budden anymore.
That's what happens with drops, dude.
Is it once, the reverb or what?
Once they're dropified, it's just like it's a mystery.
Can you play that Miles drop? That's so good.
New Dark Racial.
Oh, sounds like a god. Even though that man consistently breaks my heart, like I can never be mad at him. So yeah, everybody, welcome to the Friday pod. Hope everyone's having a good Friday or a good whatever. Yo, we're almost done with season 2.
Does that happen after this house is done?
No, it happens on March 22nd. It'll be the second anniversary of Dark Racial Humor, and we begin year 3, season 3. Your eyes look a little...
I don't feel like we started 2 years ago.
There's this thing called a calendar, and we actually did.
I was looking through my old Twitch clips.
Yeah.
You aware of Twitch? or
yeah,
Twitch,
oh yeah,
or,
Twitch, yeah.
Twitch.tv/callerjohn, dude. Fucking shit pops up on there, dude. But it's a bunch of clips from like Greenhouse and shit.
Yeah, but do you remember? Because we were podcasting before this, with the Adobe House podcast for a little bit. That was
Was like three episodes.
Yeah, that was us like getting our feet wet, and then we changed the name.
Still on SoundCloud. Do you remember the origin of the name?
Dark Racial Humor. I remember we were on the corner of the gym, and we were just thinking of names.
Was it the gym?
The rec. The rec at, yeah. I remember this so clear.
What I kind of remember is towards towards Jamba Juice.
Jamba Juice? Really?
And it was down the street where that hotel is. But on like the campus side, and you're crossing over like when it gets to like it's not downtown but like 4th.
Yeah, and then what, you just thought of the name?
I remember us laughing at the name Dark Racial Humor.
Really? Because I remember we were walking by that elementary school next to the rec, like about to cross the street, and we were thinking of podcast names, and I was just throwing shit out, and you were like, nah, you were just like, I'm like Dark Racial Humor. And then we both laughed, and then we just...
See, I remember that happening towards 4th.
Oh, really?
Might have been the same walk.
Might have been both. Might have been... Maybe they're both true, and we're just on different timelines, but then, like, we jumped to this timeline somehow. Like, my real self is dead, and I just replaced myself.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, some Rick and Morty shit, dude. That's crazy, dude. How do you even think of a show like that?
I got clips...
Literally, does anyone?
There's that dark racial. I forgot there's the dark racial humor.
How come no Twitch, one dude? Talks about how fucking Rick and Morty is just a ripoff of Back to the Future, but is it's it? Different. Like, Rick and Morty does not deal with time at all.
Yeah, it does.
Nah, it doesn't. They won't touch time, they only deal with other dimensions and shit.
I have the 8th episode of Dark Racial Humor clipped on Twitch.
Really?
Yes. And the date is April 9th, 2018.
I remember old Dark Racial Humor. This show started pretty weird. I didn't really know what we were talking about. It was kind of weird. Jay Gal was on it.
Yeah.
He's still trying to get on it. He doesn't want to put in the work. Shout out Jay Gal. Even though he did... a little bit of work, and it's heard on every episode. So he is on it in
but
a way.
But I mean, that is his work. That is his work.
Yeah. So thanks, Jay Gal, for that. Couldn't have asked for a better song.
He's still, I'm still getting fucking cease and desist orders, but I just ignore him.
Really? It just fits. It's just such a podcast song.
I say, Your Honor. I mean, come on, Your Honor.
It's like, come on. It's like.
And then like I play the air horn and the judge is like, oh, come on.
I can't wait until we're doing a live show in a theater and that shit blares over the fucking speaker. And then the drop the new darker and the crowd is going wild. All the fucking white girls.
So is there just an entirely like new generations of listeners that are watching the live shows? Or these listeners that have... Are they still like kind of what the age demographic?
I feel like
a new era of kids, of younger people that have found DRH.
This is what I think is going to happen.
Tell me.
This is what I think for a long, long time. Who knows how long? A long time. It's going to be just like this. You and I just potting us alone, shouting into the darkness with a handful of a couple hundred people a week listening, and then one day we're gonna wake up and shit's just gonna explode and we're gonna be like, bro, we gotta quit our jobs and fucking do this.
Or maybe it's not just a lottery pick and we do something strategic. Maybe that.
Nah, dude, fucking like I don't know, like for some reason we meet someone at a party and they're like, hey, I have a YouTube channel, you guys want to fucking do a thing? And, like, we do it, and they give us a shout-out, and we're just like, whoa, 100,000 listeners overnight. And we're just like, all right, time to stop fucking around.
I was thinking kind of recently, maybe today, maybe yesterday, that, like, an average of 50 views per episode is somewhat crazy.
Yeah, is that what it is? I was thinking that, too, dude. It was like, that's like a classroom. That's like a lecture.
And maybe there's, if there's, like, fucking 30% of people that... that are somehow watching it twice or something, and it's maybe like 30 people per episode. Still pretty goddamn good.
I really want to know what, like how long people listen into the episodes.
You can see it on Spotify. It's not very long.
It's so what we gotta do is just make the first part as exciting as possible.
Just bangers, dude. Oh, God. Okay. Let's fucking
just like first part's just shooting the shit. Maybe get into a story. I mean, a new story at the end.
Very Joe Budden of you.
Or we can fucking preface the big news story. Be like, dude, did you hear about fucking Trump eating his own ass? We're going to talk about it after the break, dude. And then they have to listen to that commercial. We get that fucking cha-ching. Then we talk about the shit. And then the third trimester, like today's supposed to be dark racial DMs, but every Friday, I mean, every third trimester.
I got messages lined up, dude. Don't even worry about it.
Nice, dude. Thanks to our fans for sending us messages on Instagram or Twitter or wherever the fuck.
At dark racial humor.
darkracialhumor@gmail.com. yeah, no, like the third trimester has to be like something that the fans want to like hear, like they're waiting
sports.
For
that sports section. Is
well, the sports is always there.
Is the best segment of this whole series.
But there has to be something exclusive to Monday, something exclusive to Wednesday, and something exclusive to Friday. I like it.
Very grassroots radio.
Yeah, like fucking. I don't know. We don't have to think about it now. Like Monday can be.
Let's never think about it.
Mondays with fucking. Monday fun day.
We're just in our underwear, dude.
Or we talk about, this is super simple, dude.
Absolutely nothing for audio.
We can just talk about, like, we can each pick a thing that we like and we don't like.
Okay.
That's, like, going on. Like, anything. It could be anything.
A topic?
It could be a topic. It could be, like, you know what I don't like on today's Monday?
Okay.
Fucking mugs, dude. Okay. You know what I do like?
I like it.
Metal straws.
I like it.
Cool. That's Monday.
I like where your fucking head's at.
Dude.
I like where the vision is.
I'm so fucking high right now. Shit. Nah. And then Wednesday can be... I don't know.
What if we find a song or an artist that we've never heard of before on our Spotify's? Shout out Spotify. Pay us. Maybe Audio Mac. Hey, Audio Mac. You ever heard of Audio Mac?
Audio Mac, yes. Yeah. It's old.
What do you know about Audio Mac?
What did I used to use Audio Mac for? It was just like, it was like a SoundCloud, right?
Kind of.
Like Beats or something?
Kind of.
I remember Logic put mixtapes on there.
People are talking about, like, do you know DJ Booth?
Yes.
The guy from DJ Booth, I think, has, like, stake in it or something, and he's always, like, talking about it and other shit. I don't know. Audio Mac. Find new artists, new song every Wednesday.
You do that. Shout someone out. We could, what if we did a thing where we just think of a question and it was just like, here's the random answer from a random person, and we go record one person, like, what do you think of this? We play a 30-second clip of them.
I find a person every week?
Like, yeah. Like, literally just walk up to, we force ourselves to be social, we go to USC, and we're just like, hey, what do you think of this right now? Or like, hey, like, here's a random person, think their thoughts on the election. What do you think of the election? They talk about it for 30 seconds. And then we're like, okay. And we don't even... That's all we do.
Sure.
I found this YouTube channel where this girl just goes up to random people and just asks them, like, one question. And the camera's, like, really up on their face. Like, the question's like, what's the worst thing you've ever said to someone? And they, like, fucking talk about it. It's pretty interesting.
Nice.
Yeah, we could literally copy that idea, but in audio form.
I love copying the shit, dude.
That's right, dude. That's why it's dark racial humor. Shout out Natalie, my sister. She listens to every episode all the way through.
All the way through?
That's what she said. She was probably just being polite.
Fucking liar, dude.
She fucking told me, she called me.
Bumps it through her
AirPods.
Is she still in school?
She's in school.
At a university?
Yeah.
Does she play it on the loudspeaker?
Probably.
Goes
not.
Into the principal's office and goes plays it on the loudspeaker.
No, then she'd get expelled.
The principal of the university?
Is there, what is it, a dean? Yeah. Or a president, or whatever it's called? School seems like so long ago, dude.
A little bit. It just now seems it's gone.
When I meet people that are in school, I'm just like a child. Yeah. Unless they're just like, yeah, I'm in grad school. I'm in dentist school. Like, shit.
I'm in the post-school school to get into the school.
If I wasn't in debt,
You do more school.
I probably fuck it.
The thing about school is like, it's not very practical.
But if you're,
there's people in the school.
I think like generally yes, but like grad school, if you're learning about one thing that you actually like,
super specific stuff.
Yeah, you're just like fucking. I don't know. I'm going to school to learn about the mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell.
Fuckers got that shit in, dude.
It's kind of cool how some people are just super into that.
I guess
we need those people.
That's what a PhD is, dude.
Yeah, but that's never gonna happen. Oh well.
How was your day?
Day was chill. What did I do today? I woke up. I went to work. I had a job interview to teach some kids some film stuff. And they had a nice facility. They were like, yeah, here's our editing bay. And I'm like, what?
And there's
like,
just 1,500 people in there on their computers.
No, it was just like an empty room with like 20 computers. She was like, yeah, and I want to show you the music production class. All this shit is like new from last year. That's what she sounded like. And I was like, okay. And I go in and it's just like 20 computers. Each had their own fucking keyboard. Some of them had their own mixing board. She's like, here's the booth.
And is like, it a high school?
It's like a community center for like high school kids to go to so they don't go on the street and shoot each other.
Dude.
Yeah. And she's like, yeah, we had a music teacher. But he like left, so we haven't had this class in like 6 months. And I'm like, I could teach this too. And she was like, okay, well, I'll keep that in mind. But
shit, dude, what's good with the music production classes?
I don't know, dude. Are you looking for a job?
Maybe.
We'll see. I'll see how it is.
On the weekends, maybe.
It's going to be a fucking... I only like it because it's literally down the street, which is why it's imperative that we stay in this neighborhood.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to drive to that fucking shit. On this fucking street? Are you kidding me?
What street?
Vermont. What street? Getting off the freeway, going to fuck that. I was on my skateboard. She was backed up for days. Was
like, on the 56th day of the eviction, news, dude?
Yeah. I feel like a lot of people are going to be using my truck. Like everyone.
I don't have a license, so it's okay.
Yeah.
Still have a license, though.
Damn, you should get on the... Do you even need one?
I'm trying to just really fucking able it out for as long as I can, dude. Get me some AI drivers. Get me a human driver. No, I don't know.
So I'm stocking up on Uber stock.
With this distance, I don't. But like a little... Like, we going fucking a little south of here, dude. Lemert's a long ways away from where I want to bike to.
You got that young bus, though?
Yeah, that would be something. Fucking hour transit every day.
Ooh.
Full of people in the same hot air.
Yeah, with Corona just spreading, dude. I've been listening to a lot of podcasts on Corona. Everyone's scared.
Does it, like, I asked this yesterday. During a K-Town excursion.
Yeah.
Does it seem like there's more of a hubbubaloo of this outbreak than other past outbreaks we've lived through?
I don't know the like statistics of the past outbreaks, but let's say this is bigger.
Do you think that's just maybe because you're older?
I don't know. I feel like because when's the last time shit was getting canceled?
Never really.
Yeah, like, that makes me think, like, okay, that doesn't mean it's bad. It just means they're, like, taking precautions.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, did they do that with other stuff?
I can't remember a time where, like,
I don't think so.
Shit was getting canceled. But, like, yeah, no, this one podcast was saying, like, something interesting. It was saying, like, the death rate is 2%. So, like, if 100 people get it, two people would die. So, like... Like, let's say a lot of people got it. You probably wouldn't die. Your friends probably wouldn't die, but they would probably know someone that would die from it, right? So, and it was saying, like, the death rate of the flu is 0.8%.
Shit.
Yeah.
Nice, Corona. There was a Neil deGrasse Tyson on Sway in the Morning talking about it.
Yeah.
But I didn't really watch it. But I just thought that was kind of funny that Neil deGrasse Tyson was on Sway talking about Corona.
Yeah.
Coronavirus.
And the fucking market's dipping, but, you know, fucking sanitizing companies are doing great. Now's the time to get in on everything.
Should probably get in on some Johnson & Johnson.
Maybe some fucking Disney, bro. You know they're going to be closing those theme parks soon. Disney's going to dip, dude.
Fun.
Bob got out just in time, bro.
He was like, hold on. Like,
yo.
Hold on. I see what's going on.
I think I'm good. I think I'm chilling on this.
Yeah, guys, can I step out early?
Right after opening Shanghai Disneyland, dude.
Yeah.
Jesus, dude. The biggest thing of his career. What if Corona had come out like a year earlier and just fucked him?
Yeah. It's a lot on...
Just killed everyone, dude.
I forget who took his place, but whoever, I think it's a dude, whoever took that shit. Was a little bit like, oh boy.
What's interesting, they said, I thought it was really interesting, is if this were like the fall time, it would probably be worse. Because like, apparently it's hard for diseases to live when it's really hot out. So like, when it'll like really start getting bad, it's like probably the fall. So, you know.
Cool, dude.
Sweet. We're going to take a break. Leave you on that note. Keep fucking listening, bitches. Dark Racial Humor, episode 124. Second trimester.
It's fucking head buddy.
Astro.
Get it sick, dude.
Yep.
Oh, I get it. Sicko mode. Get it? Coachella, how you feeling? Freezing cold. A little under the weather.
Coachella. When it's here, my dog will probably
do it for a little bit. No, he don't know nothing else. We're still nothing happened. Fuck all this pretty show, slow this shit is a hole. I tried to show. You know, it was funny. Drake said in an interview, you know, I don't know why I'm not credited on that song.
Is he not?
Nah, no one is on any of the album titles.
That's some, I mean,
that's just some aesthetic shit, right?
Well, I'm kind of assuming that he's getting paid somehow.
Oh, he's definitely getting paid.
Yeah, well, then I don't give a shit. That's some Travis Scott shit. Travis Scott been on that shit.
And it's like you automatically know it's Drake, so. Maybe Sicko Mode featuring Drake. Yeah, it's kind of lame.
You just gotta be in Sicko Mode.
Yeah, dude. Sicko Mode, because it's all caps. Damn, fucking Travis Scott, dude. So he's not going to get to play Coachella because, you know, they're going to cancel it.
Yeah.
Neither is Frank Ocean.
No.
But he wasn't going to perform anyway.
Frank Ocean is patient zero. He started coronavirus because he didn't want to play Coachella.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting. The whistleblower for coronavirus died from coronavirus.
You're fucking kidding me, dude.
You didn't hear that.
The person who was saying that, like, there wasn't good enough, like, protection.
Yeah, the guy said, hey, you guys should worry about this.
Wait. The one I know is that it was someone in the government saying there wasn't, like, good organization of getting people, like, safe.
Okay. The guy I'm thinking of, I don't know if he was in the government, but he was a doctor. And he, like, discovered coronavirus, and he was like, yo, motherfuckers, wash your hands. And every time he would try to, like, put out a public service announcement, he would be, like, censored. And then he fucking, like, a bunch of people started getting it, and then he got it, and he died.
Chinese doctor who worked with late whistleblower dead from coronavirus. So it's the doctor who worked with. According to NY Post.
You know what would be a great video? They'll go fucking viral.
Hmm.
Someone gives themselves coronavirus and they make a YouTube video explaining the symptoms.
Jesus.
Day 4. I feel a little groggy. I haven't taken any medicine at all. All I've been doing is just drinking hot water.
Shit.
I'm fucking sweating right now. I'm not going to the hospital. I just want to let everybody know. I weigh 145 pounds. I'm fairly healthy.
A colleague of the Chinese whistleblower doctor who died of the coronavirus in the epicenter city of Wuhan has also succumbed to the illness, according to a report. So that is talking about a colleague of that doctor. Coronavirus doctor Li Wenliang. His mother demands answers after his death.
BuzzFeed presents, I gave myself corona and this is what happened. Dog.
You never.
Fuck, can we make that right now?
Li Wenliang, Chinese doctor who sounded alarm on coronavirus, dies from virus. The Chinese doctor who tried to issue the first warnings about the deadly coronavirus in Wuhan, only to be reprimanded and silenced by the police. Okay, so this is also a Chinese thing going on.
Hey man, China gonna China.
Our sneaking of USA. Has died of the illness. The 34-year-old, pretty fucking young, dude, was announced by
Wuhan. How old?
34.
Oh, yeah.
Deeply mourned. He passed away. Located at the center of the coronavirus outbreak, had initially said Li was fighting for his life despite reports that he had died, but eventually confirmed he passed away. He leaves a pregnant wife and a young child.
Damn. Wow.
Damn. Damn. So China was like, no, 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 no,
no. No, 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 no.
No, we're cool, we're cool, we're cool, we're cool, we're cool. Nothing's going on.
So, Mulan, how's that going to do in theaters?
Yeah, I actually saw like a trailer for that. Not a trailer, but I think it might have been like Google News or something.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh shit, Mulan.
You know, there's going to be no fucking dragon character. And no songs.
No songs.
The songs were the best part of Mulan.
Well, there's a Mulan 2?
Not the strong feminine main character.
Mulan 2?
Yeah, duh. Princess of China. Is that what it is?
B.D. Wong?
There might be a Mulan 3.
Oh, what a happy, happy day. My little baby.
Listen to that Eddie Murphy impersonator.
I can't help it. You know dragons are very emotional.
Are they?
That is not Eddie Murphy. The real one. The real Eddie Murphy was in the original Mulan. Time flies.
You know, baby, this must be a they just use an AI in 05?
Nah, they just use an impersonator. It's like in the Aladdin sequels. You think fucking, what's his name? Robin Williams would do that shit?
No.
Nah.
Mulan.
It was Dan Castellaneta, for those who care.
1998 to 2005. You ever seen Maleficent? Maleficent?
Maleficent? No, is that the...
I've seen it.
Sleeping Beauty?
Yeah, with the, like, one of the J-Lo people, but she's not J-Lo. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, fucking Angelina Jolie.
Yeah, like...
You uncultured swine.
Like, there's like four people that are like that same person.
Fucking Jennifer Aniston, Angelina Jolie.
I think it might be something with the J.
Yeah, I don't know. Why did you see that movie?
I don't know. I was probably like,
fuck it.
I was probably in Coronado with my family and we like saw a movie because that's like one thing we can do to fucking family about it.
Without fighting.
No, it's just like a thing, dude. Like, what else are you going to do?
Your mom and your sister fight.
They do. They do really? Sometimes, yes.
My mom says she fights with my sister. I've never really seen it, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just women gonna women, dude.
Yeah, the mother-daughter thing is
a
thing, just like biologically a thing.
You think fucking, like, I don't fight with my dad, because, you know, we're just cool, we're chill. Just fucking...
Homies, dude.
Just fucking smoke weed, drink beer.
Like, yo, it's crazy that you used to beat your dick, bro. Like, yeah.
Oh, God.
That shit was crazy, huh?
Oh, man.
Like, yeah, I just fucked this chick, and the next thing you know, conscious human being.
That would be weird. That would be weird to hear from my dad. I'd be like, no, I don't want to hear this, dude.
It's like, yeah, dude.
Nah, dude.
Like, imagine you're just dude. Fucking a bra.
I'm still a virgin, dad.
Nice. I mean, does he listen?
No.
Damn. And I'd be repping that LAFD hat, dude. That's my favorite hat, dude. Anytime you get your father on the landline, yeah. Tell him thanks for the hat, dude.
I'm glad. Why don't you tell him? I'll give you his number.
Don't care that much,
dude. Really? He'd love to hear from you.
I'm like, okay.
Hey, man, I hope you're having a good day. Love the hat.
I'll send him a letter, dude.
I just had to stop, pause my day, call you up, see how you're doing.
How are you doing?
Yeah, it's great.
Mulan 2.
Do you know why the Phoenix sits on the right hand of the Emperor?
What?
Why? Keep his right shoulder warm.
is his guardian, his protector.
How are you gonna look like a dude, bro?
I'm already bored.
She's both beautiful Loki. And strong.
Your I went to school with the girl her dad directed Mulan.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you think you can do that?
When you become a tranny.
Bum, bum, bum.
Oh, damn, dude. He's walking up a fucking wall, bro.
Wait, is this the real live-action one?
Yeah. Oh, the hawk, dude.
This movie got a lot of controversy.
Why?
Apparently,
he's a real tranny.
The Mulan lady. You know how Hong Kong and China are going through some shit right now?
Not really.
Yeah, like, Hong Kong is trying to become more democratic. So there's lots of protests, and China's like, no.
Yeah.
Dictatorship.
Yeah.
The lady in the movie, the main character, she, like, showed, like, major support for China. And now a bunch of, like, Hong Kong's gonna, like, boycott the movie.
Dude, she doesn't even look like a dude.
Yeah. You know, like, in the real one, like... No, never mind. I'm not going to go there.
The, like, animated one?
Nah, the fucking... Because, like, all these movies are from, like, old folk tales, right?
Oh, fucking... Fucking hacks, dude. They're just stealing old...
Stealing, dude! Pinocchio?
Is it really just fucking... Yeah.
Everything, dude. Snow White, The Little Mermaid, Cinderella. Ashton Poodle. That's her name.
Austin Powers?
Austin Poodle. Because she's...
Mulan's engaged, bro. Well, where do you want to start?
Where do I want to start?
Two trimesters in. I just so everybody knows, I got a rousing third trimester sports segment planned.
You don't want to stick around for that.
Oh, man.
Or at least do the third commercial.
You got some Romney stuff. We can talk about the cancellations due to the... Okay.
All right. Guess we're getting into that. Crowded race for the 2020
presidential nomination. Many taking. Okay. This actually has nothing to do with that. And
what the fuck?
Fired. Yeah, it's about fucking the Democratic candidates at South by Southwest. I have to sneeze, so you should start talking.
South by Southwest has been canceled. Wait, we already talked about that.
Briefly, it was kind of like a foreshadowing.
Let's talk about...
That's good potting.
Young Spotify.
Let's talk about the South by first.
It's canceled because they don't want to give everyone coronavirus. You know what else is canceled? Google I.O. But no one gave a shit about the Pixel 5 because the Pixel 4 is horse shit. Pixel 3 was horse shit. Pixel 2 was horse shit. Pixel 1 was horse shit. Google I.O. is just going to announce a bunch of stupid crap that no one needs that's going to be outdated in a year. And it's... God, just make some fucking good shit, Google. God damn it. Like, it's good in practice, but, like, when I hold a Pixel 3, which came out 2 years ago, and then I hold a fucking iPhone 7, which came out damn near 5 years ago, I want to throw up looking at the Pixel 3.
Sorry.
God damn it. Get your shit together.
I'm sorry.
That's not me.
Spotify. What's going on?
I'm usually not like that.
But why are you now?
Because I'm angry.
At?
Google.
Why?
For leaking my nudes.
Because Pixel 3 was poor.
The battery was horseshit, dude.
You know, if you didn't do a specific thing before the horseshit, like you said, the first one and the second one, could have been a great meme, dude. I had a fucking Spotify tab. But it's gone, dude.
Okay,
but
so...
But I got it.
Spotify. Dive in, bro.
I actually don't got it because Forbes is being a fucking paywall bitch.
Dude, just drop a rack on a Forbes subscription. We got the money. We got the capital, dude. Like, there's no need.
I don't know why you're still fucking not giving these publications what they deserve.
Do they deserve it?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know where they get their money, dude.
Who fucking knows how people still write for a living?
Yeah, you kind of gotta subsidize it with YouTube content.
Spotify target artist labels for ad revenue, leaving smaller creators behind. You know how they get their fucking money? Just ginormous banner ads that move and take up a third of the screen.
But it doesn't even matter because you're not even looking at the screen when you're listening to tunes. Probably.
I'm actually talking about Forbes. But Spotify is letting people, larger artists, or as smaller artists, probably not. Because if you're a small artist, you probably can't compete with large artists and big record labels shilling money to give big ass ads on Spotify so people click their shit, listen to their 3-minute song that they put $10,000 into and countless man hours, and then people are just gonna fucking jack off to that shit and go on to the next one.
I was thinking, why can't Spotify just like be like, hey, record labels, listen.
Yeah, I'm the record label. Hey, what's up? What's going on, Spotify?
Hey,
you Swedish motherfuckers.
Hello, I heard your Swedish accent. Hello. This is my Swedish accent. Hey, record labels.
still British.
Record labels over there in America.
A little better.
We're tired of paying you money to put your music on our platform. Mm-hmm. How about this now? About a third of the music streaming listeners in the world listen to Spotify.
Spotify.
Correct? Right?
Yeah.
And
true shit.
Shit's not going to change. Streaming's going to be around for a good long while. I can't think of anything better than listening to music on demand for damn near free.
Pretty cheap. I mean, after a while.
After like maybe in 100 years, shit goes straight to your brain. But like for now, we're here to stay. You would be severely hurting without us. So how about this? You pay us now to put your music on us, or else people won't listen to your artists. Mm-hmm. And then you say, well, we'll just go to Apple Music.
Mm-hmm.
And then Apple's going to be like, well, actually, it's my Tim Cook voice.
Okay.
Cha-ching, you're right. You have to pay us
right?
too.
Who's right? Swedish?
Yes.
Okay.
We want these record labels to pay us to put music on Apple Music, because why the fuck not?
Okay, is this Tim Cook?
This is Tim Cook.
Okay, I hate him, Tim.
So they're so they're literally just like turning the tables, and then the record labels are just like, okay, well, I guess we'll just put shit on YouTube. But
I
like,
mean, what's the third? Is it Tidal? Is there Tidal. Really only three? Is there Google Play?
There's Google Play, but no one listens to that. There's Amazon Music, but no one listens to that. Even though a lot of people have Prime, and that shit comes free with Prime. So people don't need to fucking listen on Spotify and shit.
They got a lot of Prime stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know why. There's probably a reason.
Like Spotify could be, they're probably not there yet.
It's still kind of small.
Yeah.
I mean, man, I was watching, there's a tweet from someone in TD, an executive, and they were like, I think it was maybe Punch, and he was like, when are people going to realize that this music business shit is a 100-year-old just racket scheme?
Yeah.
and especially with the Meg Thee Stallion stuff of signing to a publishing deal that's kind of fucked, which might not seem as fucked, a DJ booth. The person who I was talking about before, the editor-in-chief of it, apparently found the contract, which I don't know where you find a fucking contract for people. Maybe it's public.
Maybe it's fake.
Maybe it's fake. But he put some stats up, and it was kind of, you know, not too bad. But yeah, with all that shit, it's kind of like,
I love
Button's yelling about it as always. Like, he's been yelling about it since Lil Yachty was chilling. And I saw another tweet that was like, y'all were fucking roasting mans for yelling at Yachty.
Remember when Yachty was like young and innocent? Then after he got yelled at by Joe Budden, he like dyed his hair black. It's all slick back. He's just like tired.
Bro, I was watching that shit. Well, because, and he, Budden's actually kind of like, especially with like a platform that he's growing now of like just people listening to him.
Yeah.
He's been very, very vocal about that shit, because he was like, in that scenario of being a young person being fucked by record labels. Uh-huh. And so like looking back at him yelling at Yachty, you know, it's kind of just like, you're literally getting fucked right now. And I'm telling you, you should get fucked. Like you should know you're getting fucked. And then Yachty's like, hey, fucking chill, bro.
Chill, bro.
He said, Joe, chill.
I would have said the same thing, dude. I'm like, bro, yeah, you could tell me this like backstage, like in like a grown up voice, or you can yell at me for views. But what do you think I'm gonna listen to more? Like,
I mean, it's half and half, I think.
Like, fucking, I don't, for the Meg Thee Stallion thing, I don't really feel bad about her at all. Because she wasn't 16 when she signed that shit. She was 20. And 20-year-olds can fucking read.
Yeah, you know, there's a whole thing. It's fucking not the easiest thing to read contracts.
It's like, damn.
But yeah, you're someone, if you're, I mean, you got to take what's given to you sometimes. And if you're going to just fucking take it up the ass from a company just right away, then obviously you're cutting some corners and you're probably going to end up getting, it's a short term get for Damn. Sure.
That album was fire though.
Apparently, and this is from the DJ Booth thing again, that the negotiations in the contract had an album as a certain amount of tracks and nothing she put out yet is met that track limit.
Uh-huh.
So maybe according to the contract, Meg Thee Stallion hasn't had an album put out under I forget what the house is called that she signed to.
Huh.
But you know, just another,
just read your fucking contract, god damn it.
You know,
I mean,
have you read an AT&T contract?
You can't convince me that not reading a contract is a good, it's like,
yeah, but like it's not that black and white.
AT&T is like a little different because that's like a fucking cell phone plan versus someone owning the rights to your career.
Sure, sure, like, sure, sure.
Like, and if you don't know how to read it, find someone who does.
Sure.
And but you can know, explain it.
Nothing's black and white, but yes, that is the white or black part of that.
Unless you're just signing it for money, which a lot of kids do, then you're going to get fucked.
It's a short-term thing, which is what you're getting, and then you're fucking yourself in the long term, whether you could kind of keep trudging through on your own and not get a some lump of money right away, but probably towards the end, if you play your cards right, you're in a better situation. But if you don't want to do that, then you're kind of getting fucked for the short term.
Then, damn, dude.
But
like, shit. She's an adult.
Yeah.
Like, she's not a kid. Like, if she was 16, I'd be like, okay, like, someone fucked her.
Yeah, I mean, no, she fucked herself.
Yeah. Like, but like, now that it seems goes like back it doesn't even matter because it's out.
Yeah. It goes back to, like, that punch thing with, like, this is a fucking an old system that is really just made to fuck money out of other people.
Everyone knows that. But everyone's still falling for it.
Yeah, yeah, that's what Budden was saying too. It's like maybe in the past when the internet wasn't as big, and there hasn't been just example after example of public contracts getting, you know, not really read and understood.
Yeah,
so being just a money grab out of young artists, then you're like, maybe that'd be okay. But you now motherfuckers have the internet. And you can Google fucking, I don't know, entertainment attorney.
Yeah.
Or go to your local at law school or something and be like, yo, like, what's good, Jerry?
Contracts explained with Joe Budden.
They were talking on the JBP that like maybe there should be a hub for people finding about information of lawyers, or if not just like a hub of lawyers. Have a place where you can find out how to find lawyers or something. Or you call up my man over in Phoenix. Kind of forget his name. Definitely forgot his name. But once I remember his name in the third trimester, gonna shout him out. Dude, he's a cool lawyer that can probably help you out.
Fuck yeah. All right, we'll be back.
Hello, hello, hello. What's all this thing?
New Dark Racial.
Racial Humor, episode 1. Dark Racial Humor, episode 124, third trimester.
This is me, the record label.
It ain't always about
what you like. Sometimes it's about what's right. Dude, she could beat the shit out of both of us.
What's that melody?
I don't know. New Megan Thee Stallion. Just started listening to her today.
Is it okay?
It's pretty good gym music. Good female
squatting.
Female, what's the fucking word? Pre-game music. About to go out to the club. Fucking get some attention.
Who was that a couple months ago, dude?
Who?
There's always a new chick
that
takes that place.
Rico Nasty? I don't know.
Word.
Rico Nasty seems like she's from the 90s.
She would kill it back then.
Yeah. She would get fucked so hard by the fucking record label.
You think so?
Oh, yeah. Easily. Back then.
But what do you think about her now? Do you think she's...
I like her.
But, like, in terms of business?
I don't know anything about...
Do you think she might be doing good, Ben?
I don't know anything about her business, really. But she seems to be making moves. Like, she's on a lot of other people's songs.
Yeah.
She does a lot of festivals.
Is she a little older? Or no?
She's 22, 23. She's still a kid.
Pretty, oh, man. Pretty young.
Pretty young, dude.
22, dude. From New York.
All this fucking views, dude. Like, who would have thought we'd get to this point, dude? 65, 67, 69, 75, 82, 102, 91, 71, 76, 103, 84, 73,
really
75.
Never really think about it.
Just like, damn, all this success. Like, I'm suffering from the success. I couldn't decide whether I wanted to go with the Supreme extra large Tesla tires today or the regular ones.
You got to get the Supreme XL, dude. They put cream cheese on it.
I was like, fuck it, dude. I make three times that money in one trimester of a pod. Fuck it.
Oh, man.
This is for all the girls that laughed at me for potting.
Still haven't made that shirt.
You guys can fucking suck a dick.
I don't think anybody has laughed at you for potting.
No one's. I don't think anyone has either. One guy was kind of sarcastic.
Yeah.
But I'll let that one slide.
Who was it, dude?
Some fucking guy.
Give me the scenario, dude. Where were you at?
I was like.
When was it?
He was like over here. He was like someone's friend. I think it was Miles' friend. And he was like, oh, is that a podcast? Like he saw the sick setup. And I was like, yeah, we do a podcast. He was like, oh, I love that for you.
Was I here?
I don't know. And I was like, bitch, motherfucker, you work at CPK.
Are they feminine?
I talk for a living. They were very flaming, yes.
Oh.
Yeah. Hmm. It's cool.
I don't recall.
It's chillin'.
Rico Nasty, bro. Shit, man. What's been on your mind?
What's been on my mind? Oh, God, you don't even want to know.
What you been thinking about?
What have I been thinking about? Fuck,
what
dude.
What big questions in life are you ready to tackle at the moment?
How are we going to move all this shit out?
That'd be your car, probably.
Jesus. Fuck.
I mean, it's like...
We got a...
Couches, table.
We got to, like...
G-beds.
The worst... The hardest part about this, I think they gave us too much time. They should have gave us 30 days.
No, dude. I was saying, like each day goes... Because then it's just, like... Because you can't really do a lot on a weekday.
I don't want to...
Not a lot of people show shit at, like, 6 p.m. So it's, like, you have, like, 4 weekends to get in, like, tours.
Yeah, right now we're doing it kind of early. And, like, all these places are like, yo...
To, bro.
No, all these places are like, we need you to move in March 15th. I'm like, whoa, I don't want to pay 2 rents. You know?
I went to a place that's, like, just down the street. It's a nice apartment, but it's expensive, and it's 3 bedrooms.
Yeah, dude.
It's not ready.
Target in on those 4 bedrooms, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, most of them are 4 bedroom, 2 bath. If you find more than 2 bath, that's gold. That's fucking gold. If you find 4 bath, bro, 4 bathrooms, it'll be
dude,
fire.
Dude, it makes me want to fucking real estate about it, bro.
Me too. It makes me want to not rent and just fucking buy, but I can't do that right now.
I wonder what the fucking... The failure spectrum is on that, dude. Because you gotta fuck up a little bit to kind of learn, I'm assuming.
You gotta start building that credit, bro.
That too.
So you can get a loan to even do it in the first place.
Just imagine just fucking falling flat in your face and having a just a nice estate, and you're like, fuck, dude, now I just got this estate.
I feel like it's not like this is like a hot neighborhood.
Yeah.
So like, let's say like you own property here, like in a college town. Like, mm-hmm. I feel like it's kind of hard to fuck up unless you do something fucking awful.
Yeah. Like, I mean, there's still in and outs, but
as long as you have like a decent amount of money saved up, your credit's good, you start with like one fucking like condo or something. Maybe not even a condo. I don't know. Like a small house.
Mm-hmm.
Then like,
it's weird how like thinking about the scale, kind of like the scale of size of things you can invest in, right? Because like when you're kind of, if I don't know, you don't have a lot of money and you can invest in like a laptop or something and you do stuff, but then people like would invest in a house, and that's kind of like scaling and thinking more like bigger spaciously in your mind. And I think I was thinking about this when I was thinking about like Todd and like renting out apartments, because you like your process of thought is getting like expanded in your mind. You think about like more space and more people.
Yeah.
And then like after that, I don't know, like a governor country or something. It's pretty crazy. Space, yeah, or something.
I want to do that. I want to own a property and make people live in there for money.
Just do it in Ohio, dude.
Wait for
it. Just buy a big ass just plot of acres in Ohio, bro.
This is what needs to happen with coronavirus. A lot of people need to get it. The housing market needs to crash.
Sure, sure, sure.
Because no one's going to work, so no one's getting paid.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So they're defaulting on their loans.
Yeah, yeah.
Prices fucking drop.
Mm-hmm.
I swoop in with my good credit.
You pull up on your scooter, dude.
I pull up to Wells Fargo with my fucking mask on.
And yo, like, yo, hey. Yo.
Like, yo, I'm dub here F, for dub a F, dub fucking F. loan. Peep that 770 real quick, bitch. And she's like, oh, shit. Here you go.
She hits the horn a couple times.
Pew, pew, pew. She's like, how much you want? I'm like, give me $30,000, bitch. And I'm like, all right, for sure. And she gave me that $30,000. I match it with my $30,000.
Oh,
put
man.
Down that $60,000 deposit.
$30,000, not crazy.
It's not a lot not of crazy. Money. I did not mention that I will not be buying in Los Angeles, because that's fucking, I mean, like, this is a world where coronavirus killed half the people, so maybe it is that cheap, and I could afford that, but, you know, and then, you know, fucking move in some sick motherfuckers, and
they die. I fuck their family out of all their money.
That's right. Pay that property tax, dude, and I'm chilling on a sweet $60 profit a month. Really low, really small. But hey, it's $60 I didn't
flip
have.
Flip that bitch, dude, and then you make a cruise ship that is also a hotel.
Refinance that hoe? Maybe expand it, add another room to that bitch? Raise the fucking rent? Kick those poor motherfuckers out? Bring in some rich motherfuckers?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then 60 turns to 80.
Capital it up, dude. Capital it up.
Dude, fucking doing it, dude. Just and I'm sitting on my butt at home smoking weed. Disney Plus and bust. That's.
Hey, man.
I love it.
At least you're saying words about it. I mean,
it's easy to say words.
But hey, some people don't even say words.
Some people don't even think about it. That's never true. Crosses their mind. That's sometimes true. I mention this to people. I just like, and does not compute. Like, never thought about it. I'm just like, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Like, all right. So see, there's people, and there's things. Thinkers, and then there's thinkers and doers. I'm a thinker, trying to become a thinker and a doer. I'm working on it.
Nice. You gotta, that's part of the thinking, is the doing.
You know, sometimes when I go to the gym, I go to the gym in like spurts, like a couple months at a time, and then I fall off.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, damn, I'm such a piece of shit for falling off. But what's going on? What's going on? Oh, here I am. But then I think, at least I'm doing it. Like, mm-hmm. I'm in a habit. So, like, if I'm doing it when I'm 24, I'm probably going to be doing it when I'm 40.
Mm-hmm.
So, like,
mm-hmm.
It's not, you know, it's not that bad.
I just started
dieting.
Trying to mix one of my songs, dude.
Uh-huh. How's that going?
Not super dope.
Yeah.
Super dope, but.
Mixing's hard.
First day, dude.
Yeah, I tried to mix before. It's kind of difficult.
It's cool. Very, like, I don't know. Maybe it was the same when I started making beats, but like, you're just kind of sitting there and you're like, fuck, dude, what's really going on here?
I've never mastered before.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like that might be kind of a more...
easier?
Just less possibilities of things you could do.
Yeah, it's just like polishing it up, just throwing a filter on that shit, right?
Something? No. I don't know. But yeah, I'm starting to try to do that, dude. I was listening to you ever heard of Shot by Adobe House?
Yes.
And you know the sample of a man talking? His name is Redman?
Yeah.
That was from like a... just a fucking...
fucking what?
In like an Instagram video he did?
Yeah.
About him. Here. Work, my nigga. If I could work every day, my you nigga, recognize no the sample, sleep, dude?
Of course.
Of course. Classic Adobe House. He's talking about recording and engineering, dude. And I listened to this, and then I just hopped into a... a shitty DAW that I don't know much about. Learn to engineer yourself. Take a year off and learn that shit. You see this shit right here? You see the board right here?
Take a year off and learn that shit.
It's a pain in the ass sometimes, but I get this shit done. Look at my pad, nigga. Look at my pad. Window all boarded up. Who gives a fuck when you're working? He doesn't, dude. Let's go to the kitchen. Because everything is 150 with me. This is also an album that he said has been coming out for like 5 years.
What else does he have to say?
Look at this shit right here. Kitchen funky as a motherfucker. Funky kitchen, but bro. Only thing I need is a path to go to eat, a path to go to the bathroom to shit, and a path to the motherfucking seat to go work. Work, my nigga, work. So I watched that and just really just stumbled through a process I know nothing about and just kept on trying to learn for a couple hours.
Keep on keeping on, bro. Fucking keep on.
A fun dude. You know, I said that like... I said that sentence, keep on keeping on, to an essay in like fourth grade.
Yeah.
About like, I don't know, should there be like music classes at school or something? One of those like stupid like three topics you talk about, like should college players get paid or something?
Yeah.
And I remember finishing up the essay and like ending it with, you should, whatever, should keep on keeping on. And someone's like, you can't say that shit, dude. I'm like, whatever, I'm fucking say that shit.
Why can't you say it?
I don't know, it's kind of a weird thing to say. It's like a fourth grade essay. Keep on keeping on, dude.
Oh, man. Oh. What happened?
New Dark Racial.
I don't know. But it is different, huh?
Huh?
It is different, huh, though?
What happened?
Just the output of song, I kind of, I don't know. I think just, I kind of blame Donish a little bit.
For what? Not putting it out stuff?
Yeah, kind of. It just kind of sat there. But I could, that's a little bit on everybody, but like, there's just a lot of stuff that just sits. And,
yeah.
Especially now he's like, doing it professionally, which is dope. But like, now more attention on that.
Perfectionism is a bitch.
That's like person to person though. It's more about like the person doing it rather than the actual like song itself.
Gotta know when to just let it go. Just let it go. It's no longer yours. It belongs to the streets.
I don't know, dude. So what is the difference, do you think?
What is the difference? I don't know.
Then Tucson via here. More individual, I think.
Yeah. I think it's also more difficult because, like, there's a lot more people. A lot more. Like,
when it was like in Tucson, it was like what, 4 or 5 people sitting on the couch every day smoking weed, making shit. And you come into a house with 8-9 people who never hang out together. Everyone has their own lives.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't like that in Tucson?
Not really.
Yeah.
Like, everybody hung out every day.
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody, the individual paths kind of solidified.
Yeah.
A little bit, which is expected.
Yeah.
But like I was saying, I was a lot more optimistic. I don't know what I was thinking in the past, but I just thought of cohesiveness for a while.
Mm.
Togetherness for a while. And that might have been a little naive.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's not like fucking... Like, we fucking did a lot of shit
mm-hmm.
that we didn't even plan on doing at all.
Mm-hmm.
Like, fucking the shows, of course. A lot of good learning experiences.
Yeah, but okay.
Like,
then what I was thinking, if from chapter to chapter, the first Tucson chapter to this chapter, like what some lessons I was thinking of. I don't really know yet, but I was trying to think of that, of experiences that I take into the future that would be influenced by the past couple years.
Yeah, and it's like, damn, like, look at right now, we're a bunch of young people living in a pretty big city.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's the alternative? I'd be living with my parents, you'd be in San Diego, Donna should be freezing his ass off in New York. We never talk to each other, except for, like, a FaceTime occasionally. Mm-hmm. Then we just drift apart.
Yeah.
Like Skylar is.
Yeah, the drift apart thing gets me, dude. Yeah. I didn't think that would... Because I feel like that's kind of happening a little bit.
It's kind of happening, but, like, that's always... Even if we fucking lived together for 10 years, like, we would drift apart. Yeah,
because that's a thing.
And it's going to happen more and more and more.
Yeah.
As time goes on, especially when, like, people start fucking getting married and shit.
Yeah.
Like, I think my dad hangs out with his friends, dude.
That's what I'm saying. That is cellular.
When do you stop having friends?
Kind of around that time, dude.
My dad has friends, but it's not. He never is like, I want to go hang out with fucking so and so.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think that's just age.
Yeah. You know what sucks? Must suck. It's probably the worst ever. To be alone and also old.
Yeah, maybe.
Just like, especially if you have a family and they just don't talk to you.
That'd be kind of lame.
I'm just like, I can't even picture that because that's so far away.
Yeah.
Like, I can barely imagine having a kid now that's a child, but then to have the child also be an adult.
Pretty fucked. Pretty weird, bro.
It must be weird when your kid starts getting a personality.
Individualism, dude.
And they're no longer a pet to you.
Oh, well.
You're just like, oh my God, you can fucking talk and feed yourself. Damn.
Housing. That's kind of the main problem right now.
Hey, it'll be all good, dude. It's like there's so many spots.
Yeah, I'm saying the kind of ramps up day by day. But yes.
Yeah.
That's some shit. I was thinking about how, like, creativity stuff, like, when you're faced with, like, shelter stuff, kind of, like, fades away a little bit. You're like, oh, damn, like, this, my leisurely loves are kind of being subsided by the very real thing of surviving.
Yeah.
Like, ooh, this is kind of weird. Ooh, like, ooh, whoa, 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 whoa. the ground under you gets a little,
I'm kinda
a little more jello-y.
Kind of excited.
Yeah.
It's like a weird excitement. It's like a weird excitement.
Yeah, it's a little bit of like a forced push. Forced pushes are always kind of interesting to take.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, I guess I'm doing this now.
Now everything is literally different.
Yeah.
Things change like a motherfucker.
In a second. Steph Curry's back. I'm doing a little sport.
Oh, shit. All right, let's do a quick minute sports.
Hey, Steph Curry. Remember Steph Curry? He returned to action last night after a 58-game absence. And he scored 23 points to go along with 7 assists and 7 rebounds in the loss.
Hear that beat in the background, dude? That's what I'm trying to get on.
Did you make that?
Yeah.
Here's nice. What Curry said after the game, getting back into the swing of things. Take a listen.
It felt great. It was a lot of energy.
And it's a great way to stay in shape. And it's a great way to stay in shape.
What?
You don't get it? It's a joke. It's a Family Guy joke.
I don't really know Family Guy.
Tonight, just getting back out there on the floor throughout the 27 minutes, I felt good. So I'm excited to be back out there. And, you know, we had some good moments. Obviously, Toronto is a championship team that has a lot of chemistry and they know how to win. So for us, it was a good step in the right direction.
Wilbon, what impressed you most about what we saw from Curry last night?
It'll be a weird thing. It's kind of intangible. His spirit.
His spirit.
His spirit. And he breaks his fucking hand again.
Hey, man.
Hey, man. Hey, now. Hey, now. Say hi to Alicia, whatever her name is for me. All right, guys. Have a great weekend.
Yo, shut the fuck up, bro. I'm listening to Dark Racial Humor.
And shut the fuck up. You're listening, or you were listening to Dark Racial Humor. Thanks for listening. We'll catch you on Monday. Peace the fuck out. Stay safe. We love you. Bye.
New Dark Racial.